But it doesn't stop there, my brothers. It doesn't stop there. My question to you today is, my question, or you could say, the food for thought that I leave you with today is that we need to ask ourselves, how much have I done for my Akhirah? How much have I done for my afterlife? How much have I done in regards to me meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You have the famous story of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Upon occasion, Zayd bin Arqam radiallahu anhu, he mentions, he says, that we were sitting with Abu Bakr Siddiq whilst he was the Khalifa. And whilst he was sitting there, he asked for a glass of water. So we went and got the water for him. And when he was about to drink the glass of water, he started crying. He cried so profusely that Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he fell unconscious. So when we woke him up, we asked him, oh, Abu Bakr Siddiq, why are you crying? What is wrong with you? So he mentioned an incident in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, you know what happened whilst I was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Upon occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whilst I was sitting with him, he was looking towards one direction and he said, ilayka anni, ilayka anni. He said, get away from me, get away from me. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu says, I looked at the Messenger of Allah and the direction he was facing, I couldn't see anything. So I said, oh Messenger of Allah, who are you talking to? Araka, I see. Tadfa'u shay'an, I see you pushing something away, but there's nothing there. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh Abu Bakr, the dunya, it came embellished with, adorned with all the blessings that it can have in the dunya. And it came to me and it was saying, take me, take me. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that I said, ilayka anni, get lost, get away from me. Because I do not desire the dunya, I desire the akhirah. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, when he mentioned this story to Zayd bin Arqam, he says that the dunya also mentioned to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that, oh Messenger of Allah, you escaped my grasp today, but the people after you, your followers, they will not escape from me. They will not escape from me. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, I know this very well, my brothers. Why was Abu Bakr Siddiq crying? He was only crying because he had a glass of water which was mixed with honey. And he actually felt that this is the blessing of the dunya which Allah is giving me. Maybe this is a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And just imagine for a second, brothers and sisters, imagine for a second how many blessings of Allah are we indulged in, and how many times do we actually ask ourselves that, is this a blessing from Allah, or is Allah giving my reward which is supposed to be stored in the akhirah, He's already giving it to me in this dunya. Upon occasion, you have another companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Talha bin Ubaidillah radiyallahu anhu, great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Upon occasion, Aisha radiyallahu anha says, the Messenger of Allah was sitting with the companion, and whilst he was seated there, I heard him from the hujra, from my room. He was talking to the Sahaba and he said, Man sarrahu an yandura ila rajulin qad qada nahbahu, whoever wants to see that person who has fulfilled his pledge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in giving his life for the sake of Allah, فَلْيَنْدُرْ إِلَىٰ طَلْحَ, let him look at Talha bin Ubaidillah. Because this man, he has fulfilled his pledge with Allah and he's going to be in paradise. This Talha bin Ubaidillah, upon occasion, Utaybah bin Sa'id rahmatullahi alayhi, he mentions, he says, I came to visit my friend Talha bin Ubaidillah radiallahu anhu, and he was sitting there, his face was pale and he was looking really upset. So I said to him, Oh Talha, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? So Talha said, I have a problem. So he said, look, I'm your friend. If you have any problem, tell me, I will sort that problem out. He said, you're a very good friend, but there's an issue which I want to discuss with you. He said, go ahead, tell me. He said, I have some wealth with me. I have some wealth with me, and I fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me my reward, not in the akhirah, but in the dunya. So Qutaybah bin Sa'id rahmatullahi alayhi said, that when he was narrating this story, he said, I said to Talha, why don't you distribute all the wealth? No issue, no problem. So he says he spent every dirham dinar that he had in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now listen to this very carefully, my friends. What did Qutaybah bin Sa'id say? Somebody asked him, he said, Shaykh, how much money did he actually have? You know, today you have 20 pounds, 30 pounds, you start thinking twice, how much should I give in the path of Allah? And you find it very, very tight. I find it very, very difficult as well. Qutaybah bin Sa'id says, at that moment, the reason why he was upset was because he had 400,000 dirhams with him. And he spent every single dirham in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because they knew, La aisha illa aishul akhirah. There is no life except for the life of the akhirah. And this is what we need to understand, my friends, my sisters, beloved brothers and sisters. We need to understand, we need to do something for the akhirah. And for this, We need to contemplate and think to ourselves, how much have I done for my Akhirah? How much have I earned for my Akhirah? You will see all the pious individuals of the past Ummah, of our Ummah, all the pious scholars, all the Ulama, and all the Mashayikh, and every single pious individual, he would always live with this concern on his mind that I need to do something for my Akhirah. And if we don't have this mindset, and if we don't have this concept in our minds, then the reality is we are living for the dunya and we don't have anything for our Akhirah. Mufti Shafi Sahib Rahmatullah Ali, the author of Ma'riful Quran, great Shaykh, great scholar, he mentions, he says, now just imagine this, he gives a scenario, he says, imagine this. He says, somebody gives you an option of living in two homes. One home is a mansion. You have everything that you require in that mansion. You know, your jacuzzis and you've got your ensuite, everything you've got in that house, that mansion. You have hundreds of bedrooms, you have hundreds of bathrooms, and you have a nice swimming pool in the back as well. Now, you have an option of choosing that house, but the condition is you can only live there for 2-3 months. And then Mufti Shafi Sahib Rahmatullah Ali, he mentions, he says, then you have another option of choosing one simple house, a terraced house, and you have the bare minimum inside that house. He asks the question, he says, which one would you choose? The first one where you only have 2-3 months of living inside that house, and in the second house, you have an option of living in that house, but there's no time limit, you can live there forever and ever. And Mufti Shafi Sahib goes on to explain, he says, the mansion, that is the dunya, and that simple house which you have an option of living in, that is the Akhirah. However, it is up to you how much you adorn that house, and that adorning will take place in this dunya, my friend. Ali radiallahu anhu used to mention, la dara lil mar'i ba'da al-mawti yaskunuha. There is no home for a human being, there is no home for a man. La dara lil mar'i ba'da al-mawti yaskunuha. There is no home for a human, for an individual, after he passes away and leaves the dunya, that he will reside in. Illa allati kana qabla al-mawti yabniha. Except for that home wherein he built it whilst he was alive in the dunya. Fa in banaha bi khairin taba maskanuha. If he built it in the dunya with khair, with good a'mal and with concern, then when he goes into the grave, that home will be very beautiful for him. Wa in banaha bi sharrin khaba baniha. And if he built it with bad actions and with no concern for the Akhirah, then his home will be destruction for him in the Akhirah. So as I was mentioning, my friends, my brothers and sisters, first of all, I leave you with a few points. I don't want to talk too much, it's taken, then people will start going to sleep and then we'll have to wake them up for Fajr Salah. So you need to understand, first point is that we need to understand, we need to have concern for the Akhirah. And one of the best methods of this is that either fix a time during the day, either in the morning or in the evening, when you're just before going to sleep, you should try to do this. When you close your eyes, and after you've been on your social media, and you've played on your phone as much as you want, put the phone away for half an hour, and because some people actually sleep with their phone as well, mashallah. Allah bless them in that action of theirs. But some people actually live with their phone. I was reading an article, I mentioned this in one of my talks as well. Yeah, there was an article where a girl, every 2 hours, just to update her status on Facebook, every 2 hours, she put an alarm on her phone, so that she could change her status. And this was a real story, and I was shocked to make. SubhanAllah, somebody can be so attached to Facebook. So put your phone away, put everything away. Before going to sleep, close your eyes for 10-15 minutes. Ask yourself, what did I do during the day in regards to my Akhirah? Have I done anything for my Akhirah? And most likely, people like myself, people like you, the answer is going to be, I haven't done anything. So during that period of 10-15 minutes, do a bit of tasbih, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Do a bit of istighfar, so that if you do die during that night of yours, then inshallah, those actions which you did before you went to sleep, they will be a means of you entering paradise, inshallah. And if you don't enter paradise, at least it will make your scales on the Day of Judgment much heavier in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the first point. Does everyone understand? In regards to this, no one sleeping, are they? Okay, next point, second point. Second point is, that's why brother was saying to me, sit down on the sofa. There's two reasons why I didn't sit down. One reason is, I probably will go to sleep. And the second reason was, I remember there was a sheikh, I don't want to mention his name, there was a sheikh, he was giving a talk. And whilst he was giving a talk, bichara, he was giving a long talk, he was in the Urdu language. And mashallah, it was a big gathering, hundreds of people sitting there. And then he kept on talking for 2-3 hours. And all of a sudden, there was only one person left. And the sheikh looked at the person who was sitting there and he said, Jazakallahu khairan. May Allah reward you so much. You know, you sat all through that long speech of mine. And you know, I'm very grateful because he was sitting on the chair. He said, I'm very grateful to you that you lasted this long. Everyone else ran away with whatever excuse. But that person, he said, Shaykh, the reality is I wasn't listening to your talk. You're sitting on my chair. I need to take it home. I need to take it home. So that's why I was saying they are rather stand up so that they need to go home to the mashallah. As I was mentioning, second point is that we need to try to recite as much as possible in abundance the Quran, because this is our source. As much as possible, the more we recite the Quran, the more the Quran, the barakat and the blessings of the Quran will have an effect on our life. So first point is 10-15 minutes on a daily basis. Even if you don't get 10-15 minutes, some people say, Shaykh, I'm so busy. Even for 2 minutes in the night, before going to sleep, reflect upon what you have done for your Akhirah. Second point is, during the whole day, if you can't do it Monday to Friday due to work or for whatever reason, then at least on Saturday, Sunday, you should make a ma'mool, a practice of reciting at least one page from the Quran. One page from the Quran. If you don't fix the time, you're not going to do anything. We've got time for social media, we've got time for friends, we've got time to meet our loved ones. But if you don't take time out for the Quran, then it's never going to happen. You need to fix the time. And the third thing is, my brothers, is that we need to sit in the company of the ulama and those individuals who possess the concern and the fikr of the Akhirah. If we do these three things, inshallah, it will make it easier for us and it will build a bridge for us to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is everyone ready for this, inshallah? Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give, first of all, me the ability to act upon what's been said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability and tawfiq, the brothers and sisters, the ability and tawfiq to have concern for the Akhirah. And may Allah make this gathering of ours a blessed gathering. May He accept this gathering of ours. And may Allah make this gathering a means of us entering Jannatul Firdaus. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam.